I'd never driven 11 hours to try out for a band before, and my initial reaction was, I think I'm lost, and I need to call them and make sure that I'm on the right road, because all I see is farmland, you know, cornfields and you know, buggies. But I wasn't lost. This is just a metal band from, you know, an Amish town, Amish country.
We had done our first full US tour in 2005 after our first record, Thrill Seeker, came out. Our vocalist at the time, Josh McManus, sent us an email shortly after the tour that was basically just like, guys, I can't hack it on the road, I don't want to tour, sorry, I'm quitting the band. Which was devastating because, you know, we just put out this record and had some nice buzz around the band and stuff. We had to cancel one tour that we had coming up right after, and we took a fill-in, but his voice just wasn't what we were looking for, so we had a couple guys try out and put out some feelers on MySpace. And that's how we found out about Jake Luhrs, our current singer.
My buddy sent me the record Thrill Seeker from August Burns Red, and he was like, man, I think you really like this music. And I checked it out and I just thought it was amazing. I was like, man, I wish I could be in a band just like that. And literally like a month later, I got a phone call from my buddy John Fowler, and he said, you know, August Burns Red's looking for a front man. And I was like, well, I live in South Carolina, there's no possible way this is gonna happen. He said, just shoot him an email or a message through MySpace.
Jake just caught wind that we were looking for a vocalist, and he drove up from South Carolina to try out for us.
I quit my job that day. I packed all my stuff in my little 89 Honda Civic hatchback, and then I just took off for the road. I was definitely a little intimidated. They sounded pretty heavy and aggressive on record, but they definitely didn't look it when I met them in an egg room of a barn. I remember, you know, talking to Brent and asking him, hey, like, can we maybe go grab some food real quick and kind of break the ice? And they didn't seem very interested in that. They just wanted to get straight to business.
He arrived and immediately we were like, dude, you're trying out like right now. And we threw him straight in there and we just played like a generic breakdown and made him scream over and just kind of ad lib. You know, I guess the rest is history. We liked him. We took him on tour for a long time, and now he's obviously a very important part of the band. The American Legion is kind of where we got our start as far as playing locally. That was like the staple place to play for Lancaster hardcore bands. I used to book shows there. I did a lot of local promoting and started getting into booking some more smaller national tours. What I would do is I would get an offer from an agent. Cool, I'm booking it at this American Legion Hall and my band August Burns Red is gonna open. It was a great outlet for us to finance our band and also to give us an opportunity to play some good shows. We actually played the Thrill Seeker record release show at the American Legion Hall. It was the biggest show that I think has ever gone on there, and I'm glad that it went off without, you know, getting shut down by the cops or anything, because I think there are way too many people there than should have been inside a room, because it was pretty small space.
We are here in Lancaster, Pennsylvania at the Chameleon Club, which is first, I guess, real venue we started playing at in our hometown. We graduated from the Legion Hall to this place. This is where we got our start playing real shows, I guess.
For August Burns Red, feels great to be here tonight.
The first time we ever played here was actually opening up for 18 Visions. I remember we had just signed with CI Records, which is, you know, the local record label that we started out on. We were supposed to sell tickets for the show as like the local opener. And I think we sold 8 tickets, and there was probably like 115 people at the show. It was a pretty small show. When we were coming up, the hardcore scene was, I mean, that's what we came up in. It was like super tight knit. There was probably like a good 100 people or so that were like commonly going to every single hardcore show that was coming through town, be it at a fire hall or an American Legion or, you know, something a little bigger here, the Chameleon Club.
When we would travel around, you like groups have like towns had like the different way that everyone moshed. Here in Lancaster, it was ridiculous.
We were like, known for our acrobatics.
It was like
acrobatic moshing.
It was nuts. Everyone's doing like no-handed cartwheels and like
Yeah, it wasn't like a violent pit.
It was like a
finesse pit.
It was nuts.
Like, get your space and do like the most like ninja moves you can do.
Yeah.
It's true. Like New York mosh was way like harder and like
it's just, I'm gonna punch you in
like,
the face.
Like you would get hit and it would hurt.
Yeah.
Lancaster was like, no, we're not gonna hit each other on purpose. We're just gonna like do big kicks and cool moves.
And no one's hitting each other on purpose because everyone's friends.
Right.
It's like, oh man, you don't want to hit Brian in the face or whatever. Like,
we have a like a vibrant music scene that supports music, and we're lucky because it's not a it's not a major market. Yeah. But other bands come through knowing that they can draw a crowd in Lancaster, that people come to shows here.
This is the place to play if you're in this world of music at all. You're going to play at the Chameleon Club. I mean, it was a place where local music actually flourished. It's because everyone was willing to kind of put in the work to support a local scene. They weren't afraid to go drop $5, $10 here on a show. And it was worth the time for them, and it was a lot of fun for everybody. I think that for me, Lancaster is a place when you grow up here, it kind of keeps you a level-headed and humble person. Everyone around here is really hardworking. Since everything's kind of even here, everyone's pretty frugal. No one's looking to spend tons of money. Like, we've all been able to stay pretty humble and just kind of grounded.
When you start a band, you're just like anybody else. You just pick up an instrument. That doesn't qualify you to be anybody great, to be a therapist or a counselor or an idol. You're just holding an instrument, whereas before you weren't. But over time, I started to realize with the band that the lyrics we were writing and the music we were playing was affecting people. And that was awesome to see, because as a Christian, I believe that God gave me the gift of playing drums so that I can give it away. I love playing. I think it's for a purpose bigger than just me enjoying, you know, hitting things.
I think I value this area more based on the traveling I've done with August Burns Red, and you know, we've been around the world and I've seen so many places, but home is always home.
You know, when you leave, when you're growing up, all you want to do is leave your hometown. I think you need to leave to realize how much you really like your hometown.